All right. Good day. Good evening, everybody, wherever you are in this beautiful world that we live in. Welcome to Keep It Effin' Real Show. Once again, my name is Pete Batiku. I am your host, and we are actually live in Medellin, Colombia, where I believe is where the Most High God live. And why did I say that? Because you have beautiful weather here. It's spring-like here every single day. The food are natural. You have beautiful women here, and people here are a lot more happy. They're not really in debt, but we're not going to here to talk about that. Today's show is mainly for the ladies. Now, man, you want to pay attention to this as well, but this is mainly for the ladies, and I'm going to give you guys five questions to ask every man that you want to date, you want to marry, or you want to have a long-term friendship or relationship with. Now, I'm 46 years young, so I've been through my ups and downs with, like, I'm gonna say ups and downs. It's learning experience. Like, okay, there are no ups and downs in relationship. It's just learning experience. And every single year, every single day, it gets better and better. So I've had my experience, whether it's good or bad, with different women, and I never look at it as a failure. I always look at it as an experience. So I'm going to give you five questions, ladies, women, chica, to ask a man every time if you want to have a relationship with this guy, you want to be married to this guy, or you want to have a long-term friendship. The first question, a woman. Now, you don't have to ask this question in an order, but when the time is right is when you want to ask, you know, the question. And here am I, my left here, I have the lovely Miss Vigas. Is that how you pronounce your last name?
Hola, mi nombre es Luisa Villegas. ¿Cómo están?
Okay, bueno, okay. So she's going to give some few words at the end, but it's going to be in Espanol. So question number one, ladies, you need to ask your man, who are you? Okay, you got to ask a man who is he. If he doesn't know that question, that is a sign of a red flag. That is a man that is just out there trying to get a one quick lick, that has no vision or whatsoever. Like, if you ask me, who are you? I must tell you, my name is Pete Batiku. I am a son of the Most High. I am a king. I rule this world. I'm a visionary man. I'm an entrepreneur. I'm a father. That's a general example of who I am. And if you ask me where I'm from, I'm going to tell you I'm an Israelite. I was born in Africa, but I'm a true Israelite. I know who in the hell I am, so you can't tell me I'm a Negro, I'm a nigger, or I'm this, I'm that. I'm going to tell you exactly what I am according to the Bible. All right? So ask the man, who are you? If they have to think about it, guess what, ladies? They don't know who this man, they don't know who they are. Question number two, very important question. How does he treat his mother? Okay. If he treats his mother like shit, he's going to treat you like shit. Now, in the beginning, he may be, you know, a man may be super nice. He may be open doors. He may be a polite. But give it a couple weeks, or give it a couple months, or give it a year, you're going to see the true color of this real man. Okay. How does he treat his mother? How did you talk to his mother? Does he call her the B word? Or does he call her a queen? All right. These are the questions that you have to ask. All right. Like, I never call my mom by her first name. I always call her mother or mom. I never call her by the first name, but out of a respect. Okay. So how does he treat his mother is extremely important. Question number three. Another important one is, does he have a vision? Very important, ladies. Like, so these are questions you'd be asking your man. How much money does he make? Or what you do? Those are the wrong type of questions in the beginning. You can ask those questions later, but that's not very important. Okay? Because you'll get the answers from these five questions that I'm laying out for you, ladies. Okay? Does he have a vision? Because a man with a vision is not going to end up in fucking jail. It's not going to get locked up. Okay, because why? He has a goal. He wakes up every morning that I need to accomplish. Also, ladies, don't get mad at me for saying this word here, but if the man worships you, or he puts you first before the Most High, before the Most High God, or before his business, he's a weak man. Now, I'm not saying he doesn't love you. I'm just saying if he worships you, puts you first above the Most High God, above his business, because that's how he makes his income, he's a weak ass man, and he's a very sensitive man. A man with vision is not going to roam in the streets, because you hear a lot of brothers say, oh man, I'm from the streets, and they say that with pride. I do have some friends say, man, I was born in the streets, I'm from the streets. No fucking shit, dude. You're not from the streets. You were born in a hospital or in a car or somewhere. You chose that lifestyle of being in the streets. Now, most men say that they're in the streets. They're really not in the street. They don't live in the streets. They just roam around. They have nothing to fucking do. Either they're selling drugs, or they're selling weed, or they have no vision at all. You don't live in the street, brother, because homeless people live in the street, okay? They're from the street. So if he doesn't have a vision, he's going to ruin his life, and eventually he's going to ruin your life. So you really have to pay attention to these, to what a man is telling you. Again, a man with a vision is going to wake up every day and say, I have a goal to accomplish. I need to make sure that my wife or my spouse, my lady, is taken care of. I need to make sure that if I'm no longer in this planet Earth, that I have money set aside for my family. Okay? Most men don't even have life insurance, which is pathetic, especially in the black community. We don't have life insurance, and Latin America as well. So when you die, when you actually die, you're begging people to fundraise. You're doing a GoFundMe. You're asking people to bury you. That is sad, because the other nations, the other race, don't do that. They plan ahead. A man with vision is going to plan ahead, not for now, but for the future. Okay? And question number four you should be asking him: does he include you in his plans? And how is he going to make money? That's a really good question, ladies. Pay attention to a man. Does he include you? Does he include you in his plans? What do I mean by that? Is he telling you his vision? Is he telling you the dreams that he had, reality? Is he telling you, hey, baby, I want to do this. I want to start this company, or I think I'm going to apply at this, you know, job. I want to be a musician. I want us to go and travel and see Dubai. I want us to see Colombia. I want us to see Africa or safari. I want to have two or three kids with you. I want to make sure that when I'm no longer on this earth, that you're taken care of. So does he include you in his plans, in his vision? Is he telling you what's in his heart, what's in his mind? Very important question, lady. Does he include you in the plan? If all his plan is just to smash, have sex with you, that is a short-term plan. Again, there's nothing wrong with that. It's really what you allow to happen. There's nothing wrong with that. If you guys got that agreement, say, hey, I'm just here for one quick lick. I'm just here to quit it and hit it. That's fine. That's on you. But if you want somebody to be there with you for long term, because there's no such thing as forever, either you go or he go. Okay? And it's usually the man that leaves this earth faster. Okay? So these are things that, does he include you? Does he have a legacy? Is he telling you his legacy? All right. And fifth, last and final, this is a very funny one. Every time I do my public speaking and I say this, people always laugh. Does he know how to go downtown? In other words, does he know how to eat the coochie? I'm gonna repeat that. Does he know how to go downtown on you? Does he know how to eat the coochie? Does he know how to lick the kitty cat? And to keep it simple, does he know how to fuck the pussy? I'm not saying with his penis, okay? I'm saying with his mouth, with his tongue. Now, here's why I say that. you women, you guys have levels of sexual. Like men, it's easier to please a man. There's a lot of strip clubs out there in this world, but you don't find too many women strip clubs, right? Or male strip clubs, I should say. There's a lot of porn sites out there. It's usually geared towards men. It's very easy to please men. Like a man could be watching a porno movie, he whips his thing out and he jacks off, he's satisfied, right? This, or a beautiful woman can walk by and he'd be like, and he's aroused, right? But you women, you guys operate with emotions. You guys operate with sensitive feelings and touching and the voice. Like right now, you listen to some of my voice, be like, you probably say, man, he's got a sexy ass voice. I like this guy, right? So does he know how to go downtown? Because you guys have levels. And I will say this, women have five, just like a stick shift. A man, having sex with a man is like driving an automatic car. Having sex with a woman is like a stick shift. There's level. You got level one is the conversation. Level two is me touching you, is the man touching you in certain places that arouse you. Like he has to understand what's your sensitive spot. Is it your neck? Is it your nipples? Is it your back? Is it just rubbing you in your leg? Now you can either tell him or he'll find out. But if it's taking too long, just fucking tell the dude where's your sensitive spot. Because man, I just go for the sex. Guess what, you guys? That's not exciting. And the third gear is using his fingers properly to get you aroused. This is foreplay, actually. And the fourth gear, he's kissing you slowly down to the vagina. Okay. He's kissing you slowly, getting you wet. And at the same time, he's making eye contact with you. Because, again, man, you got to make eye contact with your lady to see if she's liking it. If she's not getting excited or if the eyes are not rolling up, you're doing something wrong. And ask. And the fifth gear is you're going downtown using your tongue and your finger at the same time. All right. There's a reason why the index finger is called a fuck you. Okay. And the index finger is actually one of the longest fingers, right? It's one of the longest fingers in a man's hand. Okay. All right. So you're using your mouth and your tongue correctly. Don't use no teeth. You're taking her to another level, orgasm. Now, once she's had that internal orgasm, now you give her the dick. Now you give her the sausage. Now you give her the cucumber. Okay? So does she know how to go downtown? Because most women, they can't really have sex. They can't have an orgasm by just, you know, the penetration. You got to go oral. That's why most women prefer to be lesbian, because they know how to lick each other right. So, man, get good at eating your coochie, eating the girl's coochie, or licking it right. Okay? So, does he know how to go downtown? Also, by him doing that means he's taking care of you first, and he's not being selfish. That's the point that I'm trying to get to there, is you don't want to be with a selfish man. Okay? Now, I'm going to give you a bonus. All right, ladies. Now, you may agree with me with this, or you may not, but at the end of the day, don't give a shit. I'm just giving you some knowledge and wisdom here. Okay, now, it's like this in different countries, but in the United States, to me, I like the old school. Like, my parents, they still married. My dad is, like, I think 80 years old. My mom is, like, 60, like, two. I'm 46. They've been married for 50-something years. You know, my dad met my mother when she was 16 or 17, and they've been together ever since then, right? That's a long ass time, okay? So what I'm trying to say is when I was growing up, my mother didn't work. She was at home taking care of my brother and my sister. So there was me, I'm the oldest, And then you have my younger brother, and then you have my sister. And when my mother was not around, we had the neighbor look after us. I never went to a daycare. And when I had my son, I did the same thing. I didn't take my son to no daycare because I wanted to make sure he knows who his father is and is not given two different information. Like, what I'm trying to say is, men or women, if you know this is the man that you want to be with, on the relationship-wise, sexually, physically, emotionally, allow that man to retire you from your full-time job. Now, you may be like, well, Pete, no, I like to work. I'm not saying that. It's optional. You can find a business that you can do from home that the man can help you fund. Okay? Like an example. Let me give you a perfect example of this. In the United States, you have two people who work, a husband and a wife, or a boyfriend or your girlfriend. You're serving another master when you go to work. Then you come home. Now you have to cater to your husband or you cater to your wife. But at work, you have side pieces. You know, they call it a work girlfriend or a work husband. I never liked that shit. Okay? Because there should be one man that you should be responsive to, that you should worship. I'm not saying worship, but that is your king. Okay? Because you don't want to be too raised by two masters or have to answer to two bosses. And by the time you get home, both you guys are tired, depending on what kind of job that you have. And then guess what? Your kids is with third party parents at a daycare. Because like 20, 15 different kids out there, they're teaching your kids something completely different. I like the old school movies, Little House on the Prairie. That was one of my favorite shows. At that time, I didn't like it, but as I got older, I like it. The man will go out there and bring the bacon, bring the money, and the wife will make sure that the home is taken care of. Now, you could still work part-time from home, or maybe something small, but it doesn't have to be 8 to 10 hours. And then the only weekend you guys have, well, the only time you guys have for yourself is on the weekend. That is not a meaningful relationship. You got to find a man that's being like, hey, baby, what exactly do you want to do? What is your vision? Let me help you fund your vision. Let me help you pay for what you need to get to do. Okay? And support. Find a man that's going to support you in what you definitely need to get done. Okay? So, I have Miss Vigas here. I'm going to let her explain how they take care of men here in Colombia, because women in United States and maybe in London, I don't know what it is, or in Africa, you guys operate differently. Over here in Colombia, the women here, based on my experience, they cater to their men. They support their men. They take care of their men. The cooking and the cleaning. I'm not saying this is what you got to do, but I'm just saying it is success out here in Colombia. They don't talk back. They don't argue. Now, if it doesn't work out, great. You go your separate way in peace. But they're like, I ain't going to let you see your kid. I'm going to make sure that I fuck your life over. That's not necessary, because you have a kid in between you guys. It's going to make it even a whole lot worse. Okay? So I'm going to let her speak in Espanol. Now, if you're watching this, you can click it to, you can click the CC to translate it in English. Okay. What do you have to say? Don't be shy.
¿Qué dicen?
¿Qué tienes que decir de lo que le ha dicho?
Pues la verdad, me parece algo muy coherente, porque muchos hombres en Colombia y en todas partes del mundo, pues no valoran mucho a las mujeres, tienen que saber llegarles, saber conquistarlas, saber ganarse su corazón, sobre todo porque muchos hombres pueden tener mucho dinero, pero si no tienen sentimientos, no tienen buenas tácticas para conquistar a una mujer, nada, no hay nada.
Muchas gracias.
Con gusto.
Es muy bueno. Muchas gracias.
Gracias a ti.
All right. So that's pretty much going to end the show, guys. Ladies as well, please take note to this. Again, I'm not here to make you feel good or tell you what you want to hear. I'm going to tell you like it is, because a lot of men, even I've been a victim of this. You know, I wasn't honest with some of the women that I was with because I didn't want to hurt their actual feelings. And at the end, it was bad for both relationship. So it's always good to be straight up front, be honest, tell exactly what you want, what you don't fucking want. Okay, but I'm telling you, ladies, if you ask these five questions, okay, you have a better batting range of picking the right man. Because you can't say all men are dogs, because dogs are loyal. Okay, dogs are very good animal. They fucking loyal. Okay, I got my audience here agree with me. All right, it's you have to blame yourself because you choose that man. There were a lot of red flags. Okay, there were a lot of chances and opportunity. Now, let me say one important factor. When you do find a good man, he's going to mess up. I've messed up. But give the brother a chance to come back. If he mess up and say something, maybe something happened, maybe you guys got into an argument or you did something wrong, there's always two sides to an actual story. There's always two sides to a story. Maybe something happened with your relationship. Maybe he lost a loved one. Maybe, because a lot of men don't voice their opinion. They don't tell you what's inside their heart. All right? So maybe he went in and fucked another girl or something like that. Or maybe he's talking to somebody else on the side. All right? Find out why before you assume. Find out why and talk to him. If he comes back to you, that means he loves you. That means he wants to be with you. So give the brother to, you know, correct himself. Maybe he just need a vent and he did it in a very wrong, way. But if he comes back to you and he changes, give him time to change, because you can't force anybody to change. Give him time to change. And if you see change happening, give him time and encourage that. Just say, hey, baby, I see things are coming along with you. Just give her time, because I also did that as well. But nowadays, the people Tiku you have right now is very straight up, very honest, very direct. Don't care if I hurt your feelings, because if I'm telling you what's in, if I'm hurting your feelings, it's not because I'm doing it intentionally, because I'm telling you what I feel, and I need you to accept it and not be so fucking sensitive with that. All right? So that is my time. If you want to listen to this again, go back and listen to it again. But these are the questions you should be asking a man before you go further with them. Okay? Now, I'm going to do another segment on men, on five questions to ask a woman before you go further with that. So this is episode, just for the ladies, this is episode 9. God bless you. She just sneezed. All right, so ladies, this is Keep It Effin' Real Show. I'm your host. This is Pete Butiku, live from Colombia, Medellin. And I appreciate for listening to me. And if you want me to mentor you or coach you, contact me on IG or go to my website, which is PeteButiku.biz. That's Pete, BETIKU.biz. I'm very good. I understand women now. It took me years. I understand how you women think. I understand how you women operate. I know what you guys want, what you don't want. So I'm here to really give you guidance, and not here to tell you what you want to hear, but to tell you the truth. Take care and be blessed.
Bring the noise.
Yeah, baby.
Core 94 Medellin.
Good job.